Good Monday evening. So Democratic Senator Nicole Mitchell was back in the Senate for the first time, casting her votes today after being charged a week ago with felony burglary up in Detroit Lakes. It made for quite the day in the Senate chamber in St. Paul. Here's John Croman.
Senator Nicole Mitchell did not have anything to say from the floor of the Senate when she returned to the chamber today, but there was plenty said about her, especially by Republicans who made a motion to try to bar her from voting for the rest of the session.
We should uphold the integrity of the body.
Republicans wasted no time challenging Senator Nicole Mitchell's right to vote on Senate bills while facing a felony burglary charge. GOP Senator Carla Nelson led the push against Mitchell.
This member, accused of such a serious crime of violence, should not be voting on the consequential, essential votes that are coming before this body in the next 3 weeks.
Democrat Ron Latz of St. Louis Park said Nelson's motion would violate the state constitution and therefore Senate rules too.
Those are the Senate rules. So if there wants to be a motion to change the Senate rules, go ahead, let's have that debate. But that's not the motion that's before us.
After a lot of debate back and forth, Senate President Bobby Joe Champion agreed with fellow Democrats that Nelson's motion was out of order. That Latz was right.
After listening to all the advice, the point of order is well taken.
Republicans appealed that ruling, which led to a roll call vote, a split right down party lines, 34-33, with Mitchell casting the deciding 34th vote.
The people in Woodbury in Senate District 47 elected Senator Mitchell. They deserve her representation. We are not doing anything more than upholding the Constitution and the right of those voters in our democracy.
Today you saw Democrats side with Senator Mitchell, who, by the way, has been charged with first-degree burglary. She is making the deciding votes. She made the deciding vote on whether she should be voting today on the floor. I hope you saw the irony in that.
We should not be the judge and the jury. We should not be ahead of the Ethics Committee or the Court of Law making a decision about Senator Mitchell and her vote.
This is a cloud over the top of the Senate right now, and what needs to be figured out through the Subcommittee on Ethics. And that's what we want to do, and we continue to try to push that. Until that happens, we don't believe that she should be voting on the floor.
DFL leaders have removed Mitchell's committee assignments for the time being, and they won't let her join private strategy meetings. And they moved her desk because previously she was in the seat next to Senator Mary Kunish, who is one of the two Democrats on the Ethics Committee.
That Senate ethics panel will hold its first meeting May 7th on the complaint against Mitchell. They may decide that there's probable cause to launch a formal investigation, and that investigation could take months. Obviously, not going to move fast enough to suit Republicans who want an answer right now so they can try to make another effort to try to expel her from the Senate. At the Capitol, John Croman, Care 11 News.